Previously, I built this wobbling gearbox, and today I made a wobbling air engine. The best thing about this engine is that it doesn't have any complex valves, a crank, or even a piston inside. Let's take a quick look. There's not much going inside really. There's just a disc sitting on an inclined Z-shaft, and when you turn the Z-shaft, it starts to wobble. More precisely, it starts to nutate. Basically, we are using compressed air to make the disc nutate, and thanks to the Z-shaft, we get a rotational movement at the output. Actually, this idea isn't that unfamiliar. It's kind of like a Wankel engine, just working on a different plane. And to be honest, this is not my idea. NASA has a project that involves a similar internal combustion engine, but theirs uses two discs, one for compression and the other for exhaust. First, I made a simple design just to see if the idea would work. Oh, and before that, I got myself a compressor. And surprisingly, the engine sort of worked on my first try. Well, at least it was nutating. You don't see any valves opening or closing here, right? That's because, in a way, the disc itself is acting as the valve. So here's how it works. When compressed air enters through the intake port, the disc immediately starts to tilt, and through the Z-shaft, the top output shaft starts to rotate. But something very important happens at the same time. As the disc tilts, the front of the disc lifts up, and this gradually shuts off the airflow going to the top of the disc. Once the tilt reaches 180 degrees, the shaft has completed half a turn, and notice that at this point, the front of the disc is at its highest position, which means that the airflow to the top is fully blocked. From this point on, air only enters from the bottom of the disc, completing the other half turn of the shaft without the need for a crank. So compressed air enters from the bottom and top alternately, causing the disc to nutate. And there's no need for two separate air inlets. Air flows continuously through a single port. The disc automatically controls when and where the air needs to go, without requiring any complex valves. So I started the assembly process by pressing these small bearings into a bushing, and then attaching the bushing to the disc. After that, I placed the Z-shaft and completed the disc assembly. Then I gave the disc a good lubrication and placed it into the two-part casing. Before sealing the casing, I added paper gaskets to prevent air leaks and screwed it tightly. This will be our disc casing pair, much like a piston and cylinder. But the key here is making sure casing doesn't leak air, especially around these spheres. At first I thought about using an O-rings, but I found a very flexible TPU with a 60A hardness. Check this out, this is standard TPU, and this is the 60A version, kind of like a rubber. I made custom gaskets with it, but due to 3D printing, the friction was high. Still, for a few reasons, I didn't worry about it too much, because the real crucial point in this engine is the seal between the disc surface and the cover. It might not be obvious at first, but when the air enters, it will get compressed in these areas and force the disc to tilt. If there are any gaps here, the air will just escape through them without doing any work. It's the same as the seal between a piston and a cylinder. And if I'm going to use O-rings for these spheres, then what I'm going to use for these compression areas? In the end, I gave up on the O-ring style gaskets and got a 1mm thick rubber sheet with a horrible smell. I cut it to fit the cover and made a large hole in the middle for the spheres. So this gasket will first provide the seal around the spheres, then the seal in those areas, and finally, the seal between the casing and the cover. After installing the gaskets and covers, I made the casing airtight and decided to give it a try. But the engine did not work. At first I couldn't figure out the problem, but I think the cover was putting pressure on the spheres through the gasket because the assembly was way too tight. So to reduce the pressure on the gasket, I printed a thinner cover and... So the engine works, but now the gasket is flexing because the cover is too thin, which isn't good. So I switched back to a wider cover and added a small chamfer to the inner areas. This reduced the pressure around the spheres and also prevented the gasket from flexing. After that, I placed the rest of the Z-shaft to convert the nutational motion into rotational motion, and I finished assembling the rest of the body. Before testing the engine, I also uploaded the designs to JLC PCB. Why? Well, for this. Yes, I had a transparent version of the engine made. I chose SLA 3D printing, selected 8001 and clicked on the transparent option. They produced and shipped the parts in just 5 days. And look at this. It's hard to believe these are 3D printed. They look like glass. And they were really cheap too. So how do they look so glass-like? After printing, they sand them nicely, then spray oil on them, filling in all those tiny gaps and scratches with oil. And it turns out like this. Just make sure to select these options. By the way, they can even 3D print in stainless steel if you want. They also offer CNC services. In a previous video, I had a transparent case made for the gearbox. And now, I wish I just used 3D printing for that as well. Right now, they are celebrating their 3rd anniversary in 3D printing, so if you need something, you don't want to miss out on the coupons. Check the link in the description for more info. Alright, I'm super ready. I'll start with low pressure. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it's actually working. It's running really well. I mean, it even sounds nice. I like it. And it can run at quite low pressures. Look at this. Right now the pressure is around 10 psi and it's running easily. So another cool thing, look, the propeller is spinning clockwise right now. To reverse it, all you need to do is add one more pneumatic fitting here, like this. As you can see now, it's spinning in the other direction and back again in the original direction. Let's increase the speed a bit. Let's run it at full power. Now let's take a look at the transparent version. It's exactly the same as the original. By the way, what impressed me the most about this engine is its incredibly simple design. Inside there is only one disc, and that disc does all the work. Let's finally check the thrust. With this carbon fiber propeller, it's only making 14 grams of thrust. Which is terrible compared to its own weight. But since this is such a new concept for me, my only goal was to make it work, and in the end, it works just fine. However, the sealing around the disc, the gap in this middle section, or the sealing around the spheres isn't perfect. It all needs a lot of improvement.